Assalamualaikum and very good afternoon to all of you. Welcome back to our briefing sessions for the BAA 1131, the Engineering Surveying Camp. In this video, I will brief you about our task number two, which is the challenge setup. First, let us take a look on the equipment and the legend. First of all, we need the stations where we use the wood pack to mark it on our ground. And also, we need another set of wood pack to mark our trainage on the ground. And we need the trailer light, which we set properly on a tripod. And also the measuring tape exactly on the traverse line. Okay. First of all, we have to recall our first task, which is the setting of stations and traversing. Based on our last task, we already set up a total number of 5 stations inside our site. Let's say we have, this is the distance between every stations we obtain from the traversing task. Okay, this is the length of L1, which is the distance between the S1 to S2. And this is the length of L2 from S2 to S3. And we also have L4 and L3 and L4. And then step number two is, okay, first we have to determine then how many number of trainage to be set between the first station, which is the first stations, until to the last stations. And then we want to set up our challenge point to be exactly around 25 meter distance from each other. So what we do is, the first one is from the first stations, we measure the distance of 25 meter and we set the challenge as challenge 25 and we mark it. Okay, the challenge point must be exactly on the traverse line, which connecting between each station. And we mark it as CH25. And then 25 meters from the challenge 25 is our challenge 50. We set our wood pack on the ground and then we mark it as CH50. And then 25 meter from CH50 is our CH75, and the process is repeated until we reach the last station here. And then we have to determine the distance of every trainage to the nearest stations. Let's say like this one. Okay, we have to determine the distance between S50 to station number 2, and we mark it as the X1. X2 is the distance between station number 2 to S75, and also we have X3, X4, X5, X6, and X7. Okay, this is the distance between every challenge point to the nearest stations. Okay, for example, is the distance of X1 will be, okay, which is here, the distance of X1 is here, will be the L1 minus, okay, L1, the distance of S1 to S2 minus the distance between between S1 to S25. CH25, and minus the distance between CH25 to CH50. Okay, this is the example of calculation, and then the X1 is equal to 5.362 meter. So you can use your own mathematical skill to determine other value of X. Okay, and this is, okay, we call it as the theoretical length, because we determine the value based on the simple calculations, based on the value obtained, value of L1, L2, L3, and L4 obtained from the traversing task. So you can fill in this form based on your calculations. Next, okay, after we say we obtain all the values and all the numbers, okay, we know the number of chain niche. We okay, before we start to do the setup on site, we must do the sketching. We must prepare this sketching, okay, this sketching, I mean the sketching of you must the sketching must contain the S1 S2 S2, okay, you must contain all number of stations and all number of chainage, okay, make it properly, and then the distance of every stations, this distance of chainage to chainage, and distance of chainage to stations, you must sketch it properly. Okay, and then based on the sketching and the value of the distance, we can set up our change point on the site. First of all, we set the total light on station number 2 and focus to the station number 1. We clamp the horizontal rotations properly so it cannot rotate to the left or to the right freely. Okay. Like this one, this is the station number 2. We put a total light on the tripod and then we focus on station number 1. Okay, we focus on station number 1 on the wood pack. Okay, like we can see our friends here is focusing the telescope of the total light to the station number 1. Okay, then this is the station number 2. Okay, and then we lay down a measuring tape straightly on traverse line with guidance from the total light. Okay, like this one, we lay down this is the measuring tape. Okay, measuring tape, we lay down here, and then by the okay, this is here is your friend with total light. Okay, one person will control the total light and another person will assist. And then we can see, you can observe that the assistant here used the phone to make a phone call with another team members here to make sure that the traverse, measuring tape is exactly on the traverse line. Okay, if not, then they will communicate each other to make it properly. Okay, and then what we do is we find the distance of 25 meter on the measuring tape and set a wood peg on the ground as CH25. Okay, like this one, 25 meter we set. We find the value of 25 on the measuring tape, and then we set a wood peg on the ground like this one. Okay, and then we mark it as CH25. Next is we lay down the measuring tape, start from CH25 and pull it straight closer toward the station 2. Okay, make sure it's exactly on the traverse line. And then we find the distance of another 25 meters based on our sketching, based on our measurement. Okay, we find the distance of 25 meters on measuring tape, and then we set a wood peg as the CH50. Okay, like this one. We find the value of 25 meters. We find here that we set the CH50, and then we mark on the wood pack. Okay, next is we have to do the checking. Okay, we lay down the measuring tape, start from CH50 and pull it straight to station 2. Make sure it's on the traverse line. And then we get the reading from measuring tape as checking distance for X number 1, okay, where we have to compare between the theoretical value and the set measurement. The difference must be lesser or equal to 0.3 meters. Okay, we lay down a measuring tape here, and then we determine the distance, and then we compare with the theoretical value. Okay, like this one in this table. Okay, this is our theoretical value, 5.362. So what is the value here? Let's say 5.310 maybe. Okay, so the difference is lesser than 0.3 meter, so it's okay. Okay. And next, we rotate. Okay, we rotate the total line and focus to station 3. Clamp the horizontal rotation properly. So like this one, we focus to the wood peg on station 3. And then we lay down a measuring tape straightly on traverse line with guidance from to the light. This time we move towards station 2, like this one. Okay. And then we find the distance of X3 on measuring tape and set the wood peg as CH25. Okay, this is the X3 is based on the theoretical value we measured before. And then, okay, this one, we mark it as CH125. Next step is we lay down the measuring tape, start from CH125 and put it straight closer to the station 2. Okay, find the distance of 25 meters and we set the CH100. And then we mark it properly on the ground. And we label it. Okay, next is we lay down the measuring tape. We start from CH100, pull it straight closer toward station number 2, and then find 25 meters. Okay, this is based on our sketching. Okay, that's why we have to sketch properly, and then we have to write down the value of distance properly. Okay, and then we can set up CH75 on the ground. Okay, then we do the checking for the X2. Okay, we pull the measuring tape, lay down the measuring tape, start from CH75 and pull it straight closer towards the station number 2. So this is the value of X2. Okay, we check by using the measuring tape, we check the value of site measurement, and then we compare to the theoretical value and we put it here. Okay, this is the theoretical value we calculate, and then we compare the value. Make sure it's lesser or equal to 0.3 meters. So this is the limit. Okay, if not, so you have to redo again. Okay, maybe you confuse the value. Okay, next point is we set up the set the total light on station number 4 because we already complete this part. Okay, we obtain challenge 25 up to challenge 125 here. So it's time to move the total light to the station number 4 here, and then we focus to station number 3. We clamp the horizontal rotation properly. And then by using similar method as before, we determine the position for CH150 to CH200. Okay, like this one. Okay, one by one we set. And then we conduct the site measurement reading for X5 as checking. So this one. So the X3 and X4, we never do the check because we use it to set the CH125 and CH150. So we do the checking here. Okay. And then we rotate the total light, and then we focus to station number 5. Clamp the horizontal rotation properly. And then using the similar method, we can determine the position of CH225 to CH275. And then finally, once the station, last challenge had been set on the ground, we can do the site measurement reading to check the distance of X6 as the checking. So we write down here. So inside your presentations, inside your your report, you must submit the sketching, proper sketching, and then this also you must also have this table of distance. Okay, that's all for this task. Thank you very much for your attention and cooperation. Just all the best for you all. Enjoy the moment. Stay safe, and I hope you do well. And see you in task number 3, which is leveling. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Boleh tak ni?
Boleh tak?
Okey, dia kata okey.
Okey.
Sekejap. Ha. Sekejap. Saling. Cik tanya je, nampak picit?
Oh, picit nampak kan?
Boleh tak ni?
Boleh?
Bukan hang duduk sini pula.
Ha, tarik dia pergi situ.
Ha. Okey.
Pegang. Okey, dah.
Buat seni ya. Okey.
Lari tegang lagi.
Tegang dah.
kiri, kiri. Tengok jari hari. Okey.
Ketuk, ketuk.
Dia sedang ketuk lagi. Ketuk, ketuk.
Okay, sekarang kita telah selesai pack challenge 24-25. Sekarang ni kita nak check daripada stesen kedua hingga ke challenge 425 berapa jarak dia dalam kita punya sketch 20.252. Okay, kita akan check sama ada kita dapat tak 20.25. Okay.
Macam lawan di kaki.
Tarik sikit. Lepas ni.
Ya.
Kau dapat eh.
Tarik. 20. 25.
20 lagi.
20.3.
20.23.
23
berapa? 23 lah.
230 lah. Okey. Tak lari kan?
0.252.
Gelap
sah. Dah.
So, berapa beza dia?
0.022.
Okay, teruskan. Okay, Tania.
Terima kasih.
Bye-bye.